You're about to listen to the unadulterated word of God from Reverend David Kakati.
We exalt you. We extol you. We declare that you are God. You are almighty. There is no like unto you. Jehovah is your name. Jehovah is your name. Jehovah is your name.
Mighty warrior.
Say, Heavenly Father, you are God. You are almighty. You have done it before. Do it again. In my life.
Oh, my brother.
In the name of Jesus.
Oh, yes, dear.
Say, Father, today,
and
let your blood open the way for me. Let your blood prepare the way for me. Let your goodness go before me. Work on me. Strengthen me. And change me. In the name of Jesus. Amen. You may be seated. I pray for you that you will not return the same as you have come. He said, I will extol you, O Lord my God.
So
because you have lifted me up. Psalm 30 verse 1. He said, I will extol you, O Lord my God. For you have lifted me up. God is a lifter. God is a glorifier. God is a raiser. And so this dear man acknowledges what the Lord has done. He said, Lord, I give you the glory. Because you have lifted me. You are the next person to be lifted. I said, you are the next person to be lifted. It doesn't matter the corner you are operating from. God will bring his light upon you. I said, God will bring his light upon you. And you shall be seen from your corner. In the mighty name of Jesus. The Bible says that a man was famous because he knew how to use the axe on trees. Psalm 74 verse 5. Using the axe on trees made him to become famous. Popular. Hallelujah.
Amen.
He was not wearing tack. Amen.
Amen.
He was not in an air conditioned office. But he was breaking wood. And the Bible said he became popular through that. So it doesn't matter what you are doing. All you need is that the hand of God shall be upon you. Are you understanding what I'm saying? Selling of ice water can make you popular. Selling of granite can make you popular. Selling of watches can make you popular. If cracking wood with an axe can make somebody to become famous, then the grace to make you famous, whatever corner you are located in.
Receive that grace. Receive that grace. Receive that grace. In the mighty name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
Yesterday I received a message.
And I'm here send me
on Messenger.
And for a year I was smart so.
When I checked the message on Messenger,
Mammy who are seminal.
It was somebody sent me a message from New York. Pastor, I beg you, I want your number.
So for me, sell me your number.
He said, this is my number. I want your number.
I said, me number ni na me sell send me pe also.
He said, I've been watching you on Facebook.
Said, I'm show on Facebook.
On Precious TV.
On Precious TV, so.
And I am touched by your messages on Facebook.
Na once ma woka e on Facebook so no, akama.
From a village called Amankrum. We are affecting New York. That's why I said it doesn't matter the corner you are hiding. I said it doesn't matter the corner you are hiding. All you need is that the hand of God shall be upon you. Receive the hand of God upon your life. Receive the hand of God upon your life. In the mighty name of Jesus. And the guy continued to speak.
Said,
I am from the headquarters.
Now
I am in New York.
After me, New York.
I have a brother in Kaswa.
Me will near Bemadio Kaswa.
I want him to come to your branch. If he doesn't go to Bishop's place, it is only your branch I want him to come.
There are bishops.
Because I know that there is something upon your life. And the guy started speaking.
Now, brother,
he started speaking. And he gave my number to his brother. And this morning, with that crusade, without evangelism, without hungry, the man was here today. Are you understand what I'm saying? I say it doesn't matter where you are hiding. The hand of God is on your right. They shall hear about you. In the mighty name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
Those of you who have been praying with me, you understand what this one means.
Amen.
Amen.
There
is a prayer we have been telling God. God, the one that must receive a miracle through this church. The one that must be delivered through this church. The one that must be saved through this church. These are the people we want you to bring. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So you are here today because you must receive something. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I said you are here today because you must receive something. So you have already spoken to God concerning you. I want you to be receptive. Amen.
Amen.
I said I want you to be receptive. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Something miraculous shall happen. Another person called me from New
Jersey.
He said my child has been sick for 3 years in the hospital. And when we call this pastor, the charge is 50 million. When we call this pastor, the charge is 30 million.
So,
I was tired. But somebody said, when you pray, God will do something. So they called me from New Jersey, America.
It's your friend, if you New Jersey, America, man.
I'm from Amanfrom.
I
said from Amanfrom.
If you Amanfrom,
God did a miracle in New Jersey. From Amanfrom. I said, all you need is that the hand of God shall come upon your life. Amen.
Amen.
I said, all you need is that the hand of God shall come upon your life. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I saw him taking a woman to hospital. And they went to the hospital. Local hospital. Then they see, yeah. And so they see, Amen. Because we will tax him and who send him to and now they look at hospital. Tina, and I'm a boy. Dean and I yellow. So, who knew me? Catch me. Dean and I yellow.
I don't mean you. Yeah, then you call account. You're quite a long journey to her. No, I'm doing so. We're 15 seniors. It's very good. It's our normal. So, my name, Kofana by.
Okay. But we can find the condition to say.
Last still na onye happy.
No, not happy. No, until 19.
Yes.
Okay. Amen. Where is Sister Sarah? Sister Sarah, come. Sister Sarah, bra. She is the one who brought her. You better not tenacity. Once you are there, na lady, you catch her and say, "Eh, yano." And so na nyame de nsa, "Eh, come." Thank you.
Okay.
Okay. Okay.
Hospital. Okay. Okay. Osene kuma na honam ye ne basabasa afen su bibi abeta ne bo ti aduane ntumi nko aduane kwa ne yam a ntumi ngina ne mo na asan apie
nti eda abo ba na nanche ne ti sai
da na ye ba ha no Usman se me nko fere ne nda no me kwa na nye
okay
ti na oda ho ya san aduane ti hospital mo aba mo dai dem na me che ne se osene me fere ne nda no de ne ba ye ba no na nanche ne mu ye den
okay
nti ebedu hana obo mpae ma no okwa nya ne onu ni ya ko no na afede na ntini mu ayashi
amen yes na oyi atia
na oyi atia
pa na nanti ti se lady abayo a da nya ne ashi ti zalo da na di top of it the lady is sitting there the lady is sitting
there abana wa ha
the one that God did the people is sitting there
yeah ready and ni na manu no wote ya
ala commentators e kasa manu. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Our God is a miracle working God. Amen.
Amen.
I want you to understand that there is time for everything.
And
there is a purpose for every season under the sun. Life is made up of seasons. You must know your season. And get the benefit loaded into your season. I told you on Wednesday that if you don't understand your timings, you will be left behind. Amen.
Amen.
Many people were waiting for timings to work for them by itself.
No,
you must know your timings and seize your timings so that you can make progress in life. There is a time for going to
school.
There is a time for accepting responsibility and doing things that you have to do. If you don't do it, you may be left behind. People have served God for many years. But they are not seeing progress in their walk with God, in the supernatural, in their spiritual. They are not seeing progress. One of the easiest ways for you to be elevated is for you to be given assignment.
Yes.
When you are called and you are told to go and do this, it is a way of promotion. When you are given an assignment to do something and then you refuse to do it, you are locking your promotion. Because before God will elevate you, he will give you an assignment. Amen.
Amen.
So Moses was a common shepherd. And God wanted to elevate him into a realm of power. He said, "Moses, before I will give you that power, I want to send you first." If you accept for me to send you, then I'll give you the power to divide the Red Sea. I'll give you the power to control night and day. I'll give you the power to kill and to make alive. But first accept for me to send you a body that can be assigned, that cannot be assigned. Cannot be great. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So one of the ways God will use to make you great is that he will let your boss or your leader send you or assign you. Amen. So when you are in a company,
company
you are in a working place. You are in a place. And nobody sends you, no leader, nobody sends you. It means that they are not seeing usefulness upon you. Are you getting what I'm saying? So when you are in the office, at the workplace, or in the church, and the leader of the department cannot ask you to do anything, your general manager cannot ask you to do anything, you must cry. You must cry. God, me too, when would they send me? Me too, when would they assign me? One day my bishop called me. He said, I have an assignment for you. And I was jubilating. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I was jubilating. He said, I want you to go and hold mini crusades. Amen.
Amen.
Yes. So anytime God wants to change your level, He will cause your head or your superior to give you
answer.
Once you refuse it, you are delaying your promotion. Hallelujah.
Amen.
If you don't know how to do it, ask Him, please, how should I go about it?
Don't
say me tiny.
I can't do it.
Amen.
Amen.
Say, please, how do I go about it?
So,
please coach me.
Mister,
I want to know how to do it. Then He will show you how to do it.
Because
it is God that lays things on the heart of leaders for them to ask you to do. Are you getting the revelation? Say, Lord, change my level. Say, Lord, change my level. This December, there is something inside it for you. I was telling those in the first service, saying that the year has already ended. You haven't seen anything. There is something inside. Because people are getting their own. I said, people are getting their own. You must also get your own. Because you too, you are perfect. Are you understanding what I'm saying? The enemy has decided to make sure that you don't get anything in the month of December. In Exodus chapter 7 verse 14,
he
said to the end that man should find nothing. So the enemy has decided that when you are getting to the end of the year, you will find nothing. But I declare that you shall find something. I said you shall find something. I said you shall find something. Say, my father, anything covering my inheritance, I remove the covering. My inheritance appear this December in the mighty name of Jesus. Say, Lord, open my eyes to discover my inheritance in December in the name of Jesus. Say that. Something double shall happen for you. In Isaiah chapter 5 verse 26,
he
said, from the end, behold, they shall come with speed swiftly. Say, I am in the end of the year. He said, from the end, behold, they shall come with speed swiftly. Speed is swift. Swift is also swift. He said, they shall come with speed swiftly. Certain things must come to you. And as we get to the end of the year, they shall not only come, but they shall come with speed swiftly. It is talking about double speed. It's talking about double acceleration. It's talking about double advancement. It's talking about double momentum. Said, it shall come to you with speed swiftly. Anything that is coming to you, and it is coming with God's will, I command that it comes to me with speed. In the mighty name of Jesus, the thing that is coming to you, it is not English Premier League where you'll be showing slow motion. I said the thing that is coming to you, you don't want slow motion inside. We want it to come to you with spirit swiftly. Say, my Father, whatever is coming to me, I prophesy to it. Let it come to me with spirit swiftly. In the mighty name of Jesus, say right now, every force responding my inheritance, I break that force. In the mighty name of Jesus, every force responding my portion, I break that force. In the name of Jesus Christ. Say that. So as we get to the end of the year, the end of the year, you are supposed to walk in dominion. God releases more power. God releases more authority. Getting to the end of the year. So in the book of Daniel chapter 7 verse 26, it says that the judgment shall sit still, and they shall take away their dominion, and they shall consume them, and they shall destroy it. So the enemy is attacking your dominion, and he wants to take away the judgment of God from your life. But I enforce the judgment of God in your favor. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Any power that has seen the level of authority that is coming to you, any power that has seen the level of blessing God is bringing into your life, and they say, this blessing we will intercept it. They say, this glory we shall stop it. The Lord has gone ahead of them. I said, the Lord has gone ahead of them. The Lord is faster than the enemy. Are you understanding what I'm saying? I said, the Lord is faster than the enemy. Because if the Lord was not faster than the enemy, they would have prevented Jesus from rising from the dead. But they were doing everything to prevent him from rising. But God went ahead of them and rose Jesus from the dead. I see God going ahead of the enemy. Before they close their eyes and they open their eyes, your position has changed. Your level has changed. Your marriage has come. They will not know when you get pregnant and you give birth. Because God shall cover you. God shall cover the baby. Before they will realize, is taking place in your house. I don't know who I am talking to. I'm speaking to somebody here. Who am I speaking with? Receive this impartation. Receive this impartation. In the mighty name of Jesus. Every time you are getting to the end, the end of your life, the end of your years, the end of the year, the end of a project, God makes sure that you put great hope at the end of it. Say great hope. Great hope. In Jeremiah 31 verse 17.
Oh, Jeremiah, oh man,
there is hope in your end. And they shall come again. There is hope in your end. As you are going to the end of the year, God has loaded a lot of hopeful things for you. So you are not a hopeless person. December is your month of hope. December is your month of achievement. December is your month of reward. I want you to look forward to receiving something in December. I want your expectation to be very high for December. Because everything you couldn't do from January to November, God said the things you are hoping for, I'll package it in December. I'll arrange it in December. I will gather it in December. So he said, your hope Your hope is in your end. There is hope in your end. There is hope for 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 your end. I declare in the name of Jesus that as you enter the end of this year, something that will cause you to jump, something that will cause you to celebrate, something that will cause you to rejoice, something that will cause you to praise the Lord, something that will get into your hands. In the mighty name of Jesus, as I'm speaking right now, I see envelopes coming into people's hands right now. I see God delivering envelopes to some people. Special envelopes, sealed envelopes. In the mighty name of Jesus, receive that envelope. Yes, receive that envelope. Receive that envelope. In the mighty name of Jesus. Some of you, by the time you get home, the envelope will be in the house waiting for you. In the mighty name of Jesus. I said it will be in the house waiting for you. There is a good news waiting for somebody. Say, oh Lord, let my expectation come alive in this December. In the mighty name of Jesus. Let me tell you something. Don't throw away your expectation. Don't throw away your expectation. Your expectations stimulate God. Your expectation move God. God is looking for expectant people. When he sees expectant people, it ginges him. It sparks him. It makes him zealous, wanting to do something. Your expectation is the key that will open the doors of heaven. Are you understand what I'm saying? Stop looking at yourself and start looking at your God. Say, Lord, I believe. Say, Lord, I believe. Lord, I believe. Lord, I believe. Lord, I believe about things are possible. Lord, I believe. Lord, I believe. Lord, I believe about things are possible. Lord, I believe. As we enter into December, there are powers called hunting powers. They look for precious things and hunt for it. They look for valuable things and hunt for it. So in Lamentations chapter 4 verse 18, it says that they have been hunting our steps so that we are not able to go in. And because they are hunting our step, our end is near. I'm telling you that your end is not near. I said your end has not come. God is giving you a new beginning. In the mighty name of Jesus. He said they have been hunting our steps so that we cannot go in. There is an in God wants you to go. There is a place God wants you to enter. But they are hunting your steps. And so you cannot go in. There is a new level of opening God wants you to enter. There is a new place of life God wants you to enter. Wherever you pass, they are hunting your steps. As long as they are hunting your steps, you are not able to enter. But after today, God shall blind all of them. In the mighty name of Jesus, I see you entering your next level. I see you entering your next level. In the mighty name of Jesus, there is an opening you must enter. Say, I've said before, you are open door that nobody can shut. When a man opens the door, another man can shut it. But when God opens the door, no man can shut it. The kind of door that is opening for you is not a door that a man can shut. It is a door that the Lord is opening that no man can shut. You will go into that door in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I am praying for somebody here that by the close of this night, when you hear your name, you will be surprised. I said, when you hear your name, you will be surprised. You will hear your name somewhere. You will hear your name somewhere. Customers will be coming from that place. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Contracts will be coming from that place. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Calls will be coming from that place. In the mighty name of Jesus. I am praying for you today that God will give you a breakthrough from every family, from every house, from every village, from every community, from every city, from every region. In the mighty name of Jesus, I pray for you that you shall get contracts. Whatever you are doing, you shall get customers, not only from Amanfro, they will come from Accra, they will come from Kumasi, they will come from Porta Rica, they will come from Takrabi, they will come from all around. In the mighty name of Jesus, I am praying for you today that the Lord shall make you a sought after. The Lord shall make you a sought after. The Lord shall make you a sought after. In the mighty name of Jesus. The Lord said to
Abimelech,
that thing you are taking from Abraham, give it back to him. For he is a prophet. And he shall pray for you. Anybody that has taken something from you, the Lord shall appear to him. I said, anybody that has taken something from you, the Lord shall appear to him. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, you will be there and you will bring your gift. Oh, your position is coming back. Your seat is coming back. Your employment is coming back. Your reward is coming back. I said it is coming back. In the name of Jesus, say, Lord, arise and scatter my contenders. Say, Lord, arise and scatter my contenders. In the name of Jesus. You can sit down. I said, they will come to where your table is. I said, they will come to where your table is. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I paralyze the pursuer in your life. In the mighty name of Jesus, every power that wants to kidnap your glory, the Lord shall deliver your glory. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, every power that wants to take your glory and put it in the back, your glory is too big to be contained in the back. I am telling you something today. If God should give your glory into your hands, you cannot carry it. It is too heavy. It is more than you can carry. It is more than you can carry. This December you receive a percentage. I said, this December you receive a percentage. January you will receive a percentage. February you will receive a percentage. Every month you receive a percentage. In the mighty name of Jesus, say, Lord, that heavy glory, that heavy glory, let it come upon my life. In the mighty name of Jesus. When the Lord changed the captivity of Israel, the Bible said they were like the people that were dreaming. They were not sure whether it was them. That is what God shall do in your life. I said, God, that is what God shall do in your life. In the mighty name of Jesus, I pray for you today that the hand of the Lord shall be lifted for you. I pray for you today that the hand of the Lord shall come upon you. I pray for you today that the hand of the Lord shall maneuver for you. I pray for you today that the hand of the Lord shall work in your favor. The hand of the Lord, arise and do it for me. In the name of Jesus. Sit down. My bishop said he went to America. And then, when he got to America, they brought police escort to pick him.
Omosuma police cars any asrafo ene be fa.
And when they got to the traffic light,
and mama do traffic light,
the police stop all the white man cars.
Police for na age na bro for no almost any na.
It's a black man coming past.
Say onipa tuntun the thing.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
The police stop all the white man cars.
Police for na age na eh bro for the cars na
coming past.
Obibini me say
God will stop some things for you.
Ebade be tina na me bi ama.
I said God will stop some things for you. In the mighty name of Jesus, I say God will stop some things for you. God will bring some people across for you. In the mighty name of Jesus, what you think you don't deserve, what you think you are not qualified for, God himself shall qualify you. I say God himself shall qualify you. Say Lord, arise and stop the traffic for me to pass. Say Lord, arise and stop the traffic for me to pass. In the name of Jesus. Sit down. They don't like it, but they will stop. They are not happy, but they will stop. Because it is order from above. Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So Bishop look at Mama Vivi's face.
He says, "If I share Mama Vivi's name
inside the limousine,
I want limousine him."
And they say, "Hey."
Say, "Hey."
Yempaye ni. I said, "God will do it in your life." I said, "God will do it in your life." I activate the Ginasari anointing here. As the one that Ginasari has sent here to represent him here, I activate that Ginasari anointing for you in the name of Jesus. Let the Lord stop the traffic for you. In Jesus' name.
Oh, yes, dear.
Sit down.
Nothing.
Amen.
Amen.
One day my bishop said he went to America.
Now comes out to America
for a conference. A great man called Richard Hall was ministering. He was a healing minister. So Bishop went into the conference. And he went to hide in the corner. At the back. He didn't want anybody to bother him. Because he was just going to receive the word of God. He said he was sitting at the back there. I wish I'm wearing a suit so that I'll do some impartation for somebody. He said he was sitting at the back there.
I said, "No, teacher."
And then the man of God started walking.
Now, I say,
everywhere was white men.
He
said he was looking like black granite in the midst of white bones.
No, I said, "Cut it, chum."
And then the man came to the back there.
Now, upon the
and the man said, "Get up."
Now, upon the "Sorry."
And follow me.
Not the machine.
And the man brought him to the front.
And not
the
anymore.
Today,
and then
somebody,
Obi,
in your work,
oh,
you are sitting at the back. In your position,
oh,
you are sitting at the back.
Oh,
in life,
oh,
you are sitting at the back.
Oh,
in business,
oh,
you are sitting at the back.
Oh,
but today, the hand of the Lord, the anointing of the Lord, the spirit of the Lord is bringing you from the back.
It's
bringing you forward. In the name of Jesus, they shall hear about you. They shall call your name. You shall make impact. In the mighty name of Jesus, say supernatural. Say supernatural. Say supernatural. In the name of Jesus. Sit down. Then the man of God said to him, God says, "This anointing upon me is coming upon you. And you shall do mighty things than me." Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
The service was over. He went home. The following day when he came, these white people went to put him in corner. Say, "You black man, we are here. We have been serving this man of God for years. He has never said this in
the past.
You black man, you black man. Yesterday you came. No. You are coming to collect it. It doesn't matter whether you came yesterday or today. The Lord says your time is out.
atom.
I said the Lord says your plan is
atom.
And if God says yes,
what is it? I am.
Who can say no?
Why never got that David?
You put him in the corner.
It's almost like you know what straight.
And the man of God was ministering.
No, I'm really funny. Yeah, yeah, sorry.
He was ministering.
Oh yeah, no, sorry.
Then the Holy Ghost began to move the man.
He began to move the man.
Before the bishop will realize. The man has come to the corner. Today, God is coming to where you are hiding. God is pulling you out. I said, God is pulling you out. You said you don't want them to know you. You said you don't want anybody to see you. But today, God said he's removing the cloth from you. God is giving you advertisement. God is giving you announcement. God is giving you publicity. And the man of God brought him forward. And the man of God knelt down. The man of God knelt down. And he said to my bishop, God said, you carry greater anointing than me, so I should let you pray for me. Are you understanding what I'm saying? Your level is changing. I say your level is changing. I say your level is changing. It is not by position. It is not by title. It is by the hand of God. I see that hand settling upon people here. 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 It is settling upon people. 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 Receive the hand of God upon your life. Receive the hand of God upon your life. Receive the hand of God upon your life. In the name of Jesus Christ. Maybe you are selling something somewhere. And somebody is coming to buy. There is somebody in the area who is telling people that they shouldn't come and buy the thing from you. Amen.
Amen.
He's telling them that your things are expensive. He's telling them that your steel, the pepper is too much.
Amen.
Amen.
He
said that you like putting too much salt in your food. So they shouldn't come and buy. But they will tell them all those things. And the people will still come. I said the people will still come. Because the power of God is drawing them. Say, Heavenly Father, I need that hand upon my life. In the mighty name of Jesus. The hand of God is greater than magic. I said it is greater than juju. It is greater than magic. All you need is that the hand of God shall come upon you. All you need is that the hand of God shall come upon you. Put your hand over your head and say, Father, let your hand come upon my life. In the mighty name of Jesus. Say, Holy Ghost, this December, I want to walk under the power of your hand. In the name of Jesus Christ, say, my Father, from today, let your powerful hand come upon my life. In the mighty name of Jesus, lift your voice and begin to talk to the Lord. Lift your voice and begin to talk to the Lord. Lift your voice and begin to talk to the Lord. Lift your voice and talk to the Lord. Father, I want your hand upon my life. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you for listening. For more of those messages, follow us on YouTube, Paris Amafrom TV, and on Facebook, BCI Dominion Sanctuary. God bless you for listening.